There are three cardinal symptoms of Parkinson's disease. One of them is called bradykinesia or slowness. Then there is rigidity or stiffness, and there is a tremor at rest. All of these cardinal symptoms that respond to levodopa will respond to deep brain stimulation. For essential tremor, you know, patients that have postural as well as kinetic tremor, they respond to deep brain stimulation. Complications of therapy, which are motor fluctuations and dyskinesias, also improve. So patients, after they are optimally managed with DBS and medication, will have a smooth dopaminergic response and will spend more time in the on period. Also, the dyskinesias will be, you know, minimized or sometimes even eliminated. It can also help head tremor, either a no-no tremor or a yes-yes tremor. And there is some data that up to 50% of patients improve their voice tremor. There's a bit of a controversy whether does it really help and do they require bilateral DBS or would they be helped with unilateral DBS. My colleagues and the neurosurgeons, Dr. Paradian and his colleagues, will all go together and talk to the patient and the family. We ask them about their expectations from the surgery, what the outcome of the surgery needs to be. And we want to ensure that what they want is really commensurate with what our therapy promises to deliver. Deep brain stimulation does not help with memory problems. In fact, if somebody has memory issues, you know, to the point of having dementia, that is a contraindication for DBS. GAID is a little complicated because there are people that have levodopa responsive GAID and freezing, and then there are people whose GAID and freezing as they advance does not respond to levodopa. So if GAID and freezing respond to levodopa, then they are likely to respond to deep brain stimulation.